Okay, I'm ready to start. What would you like? This is a like a study session to make sure math techniques are okay and some of the cryptographic systems and algorithms are understood for cryptography 374 in winter 2012. Can I do number six? Okay, consider the, and I'm not sure how much detail you want me to go into, so if I'm going into too much detail or not enough, you have to tell me. Number six says, consider this linear congruential generator, blah, 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 starting with the seed of three, compute the first four numbers generated. So let me just copy that and put that onto the drawing program, which is somewhere here, it is. Didn't paste at all. Okay, I'll just have to write it out then. So we have the linear congruential operator is x of n, as I recall, equals, can you read it? Oh, do you know what I need to, you don't have it in front of you. Yeah, me neither. N plus 1 equals 3 times x of n mod 10. Okay. So, x of n plus 1, n, okay, try again. 3x of n plus 1 equals 3 times x of n plus, I've already forgotten what it is. Okay, let's just hide that for a moment. Is it terrible? I can't remember anything. Oh, it's in Word. See? It's 3 times x of n and then just mod 10. Okay. Okay, so 3 times x of n and then it's just mod 10. And the seed is 3. Okay, so what this is a question to make sure you understand about random number generators and how they work. And the idea of a random number generator is that there's some formula that computes the random number that you're trying to get out based on this formula right here. So there's the formula. So in any kind of programming language, if you were to say something like x equals rand or random or any whatever the function is, you want x here to get the value returned by this function call, which will give you a random number. And then you can use that random number to do things that require some randomness in them, like simulating things. So this thing right here is built into almost all programming language libraries. So I've given here a really simple one to do to make sure that you can exercise it. And the meaning of this notation here is that the random number I'm getting, this number right here that I'm getting, so this right here is the formula random. And we can see that the formula random depends on the previously computed random number. So if I start with x of 3, it says here seed equals 3. That means that somebody, you, the programmer, or the system made the assignment of 3 to the first random number possible. Okay, so that means right here, I currently have the value 3 stored for this thing right here. And then when the user calls, and it doesn't have to be x, it can be a equals random. It can be anything. This is just a variable right here, so I could have it inside a loop or a function call or anything, but the next time this thing is called, it's going to use the previously computed value and then plug it into this formula. So the previously computed value was 3. So that means the next time it's called is called the x of 1 time, because that's the 1th time it's called. This is the initial time, this is the 1th time it's called. So this is going to have the value 3 times 3, which is 9, and then mod 10. So mod 10 means I am allowed to use the integers from 0 through 9, which is why I picked it, because it's really easy to calculate. So this equals 9. So the first number, so the first time I call this, let me pretend down here like I have a for loop. For, this is just a standard loop. For I equals 1, I less than equal 4, I increment. So I want to do this 4 times and just do a print of the call to random. Okay, so that's all. I'm just going to step through this loop 4 times. I is 1, 2, 3, 4, and every time the only thing I'm doing in the loop is printing out the current return from the random number generator. So here will be my output down here. So it's initialized to 3. The first time I call it, I'm going to get a 9. Okay, so that's one time through this loop. Next time through the loop, I is 2, so I want to call the random number generator again, so that means I'm going to calculate the next number that's computed right here. So I say 3 times, this is x of 2, n plus 1 is 2, which means n must be 1. So 3 times x of 1, which is 9. 3 times 9 is 27 mod 10. That equals 7. Okay. Is that okay? Mm-hmm. Not really?
Why do you stay with x as 1, though? Why do you go higher? Like 2 or 3?
Oh, this number right here, this number is the number of times I have called this function.
Yeah.
That's all it's for. So the when I initialize, this is just like this is kind of like the name in a way. The initial value of this thing right here, which is why I use a 3 here, the initial value of this thing is 3. The first time, the very next time I call it, which I'm going to label 1 here because it's 0 plus 1, the next time I call it, I use 3 because this is the x of the 0 time. Huh, I think I see what the problem is. Let me do a little aside right here. So x of 0, let's say x of n and x of n plus 1. Let's do it like this. Okay, so if I start here with n is 0, I'm going to get x of 0, and then that's going to give me x of 1. Right? So for n equals 0, if n equals 0, I'm going to be able to get x of 1. If n equals 1, so if I have n equals 1, x of 1, now n has the value 1 right now for this row. This is a new row. If n now has the value 1, I'm going to be able to compute x of 2. Once I know what the value of x of 2 is, I'm going to be able to compute x of 3. So x of 2 is used to compute x of 3. Okay? So suppose, let me draw another picture right here to try to get this idea in. So I'm going to make a new, I need a new piece of paper here. So let's make just x going this way. X goes this way. And this is just my value, x of, no, I don't want to say that. Okay, so here's x going this way. No, sorry, wrong. This is n. Okay, n is going to start here at 0, and then I'll have 1, and 2, and 3, 4, 5. Okay, good enough. Can you see that okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm telling you that, and this right here is x. And if it bothers you to have x up here, I can change it to y if you want. It's just a name. Okay? So this is x of n going this way. So I am telling you x of 0 equals 3. So when n equals 0, I am telling you x of 0 equals 3.